Let's talk about how to round numbers. So we're going to have to break all of our digits up into two groups, but before we do that, I think for even something as simple as rounding, it's helpful to have a definition. So rounding a numerical value means replacing it with another value that is approximately equal, but is shorter slash simpler. And the big key thing here is that you're trying to make it approximately equal. That's the whole point of rounding. It's basically the same number. All right, so with that in mind, let's go to our two groups of numbers. And the rule we're going to learn for this is that if the first digit you're getting rid of is in between 0 and 4, drop it and leave the rest the same. And so those are all the lower numbers, and then the higher numbers, 5 through 9, the rule is that if the first digit you're getting rid of is between 5 and 9, drop it and add 1 to the previous digit. All right, so that's our two basic rules, and now let's see some examples that show how those rules work. So here we have two very similar numbers. We start with 1.684, and we're going to round it to 3 digits. And so I always like to mark out the 3 digits that we're going to keep, and it's always going to be starting on the left-hand side. And so 1, 2, 3, and then what I like to do is I make a box in between our cutoff point. So basically, the last one with a line under it is our last place that will exist in our rounded number. And then our 4 is our first number that gets cut off, and it's not going to be in our next number, in our rounded number. And so I make a box in between these two, and then I just like slash it in half. And this helps me visualize what I'm focusing on for the problem. And so in this case, the number that could change, that's our 8. And that's always the one that's on the left side of our box. And then the number 4 is our number that decides if it will change. So 4 controls 8's fate. And so in this case, that 4 is in our first group of numbers between 0 and 4, which means that it is not high enough to round up. We're just going to leave it the same. So our final answer for this is 1.68. And now let's do a very similar example, 1.685. We're also going to round this one to 3 digits. And so I like to count up my 3 places, make my box, split it in half, and now my 8 is still my number that could change, the left-hand side of the box, and now 5 is the number that decides if that 8 will change. And in this case, the 5 is in that second group of numbers. It's in the 5 to 9, which means that you will have to add 1. And so we're going to round up in this case. We're still going to drop the 5's place. That's not going to show up in our rounded number, and our final answer will be 1.69. All right, so those are a couple of basic examples, and so now let's just drill this concept by rounding the same long number 6 different ways. And so our number 58.67048, first let's just round it down to 6 digits. So I count to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 digits, and that means that my cutoff point between what's going to show up and what's not going to be there is 4 and 8. In this case, that 8, the number on the right-hand side, it is big enough that we're going to have to round up. So our final answer is 58.6705. If we round to 5 digits, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Our box is in between 0 and 4, and so 4 is not high enough to round up, so we're going to be left with 58.670. So now rounding to 4 digits, we have 58.67. We draw our box. And so in this case, 0 is not high enough to make the 7 round up, so we're just going to end with 58.67. And now 3 digits, we have our box in between 6 and 7. We're going to round up because 7 is high enough, so our final answer is 58.7. All right, and so next we have just rounding to 2 digits. And so a couple of things. One, it doesn't change anything if our box and where we're rounding from is right in the middle of that decimal point. So it doesn't matter. We're still just going to look at 8 and 6. The decimal point doesn't change anything. And the other thing I want you guys to notice is that as we've gotten farther and farther away, we don't care about all the numbers that come before what we're rounding at. So at this step, we don't care about 7048. Those are just kind of stragglers. The only one that really affects the rounding is that 6 on the right-hand side of the box. Now we're going to round to one digit, so we just have our dash under that 5, and our box is in between 5 and 8. So we're going to put a slash down there, and it is going to make us round up. So we are going to round up to 6, and now in this case, be really careful that you round to 60. That's the answer. I see a lot of students make this mistake where they would say just 6 is the answer. So you don't want to put just 6. And the reason is that, remember, the whole point we're rounding is that rounding should keep the general value of the number the same. That's the whole point. We don't want to just write 6. That has nothing to do with 58. We know that our number is, you know, closer to 60 than it is just the number 6. So remember that no matter what, you can always kind of check your rounding by saying, does this make sense? Is it keeping the general value of the number the same? And that's going to help make sure your number is correct. All right, and that's the end. Thanks so much for watching. Bye-bye.